We are on Baba Batra, Perek Vav Mishnah Dalet, fourth Mishnah, the sixth chapter of Masechet Baba Batra. In this Mishnah, we discover how spoiled we are in our lives today, because we're going to learn about standard size, house size in the times of the Mishnah. This is a Mishnah. Amachem akom l'chaveru livnot lo bayit. When you sell a place, meaning a guy needs space to build a house, so how much space do you need? Furthermore, your friend is giving you space to build a beit chatnut, a wedding home for his son. His son is getting married and needs an apartment for his new family. Ubeit amanut lebito, or his daughter's husband died and she's now returning to her father. Interesting. The Bartimaeus says, kishemet ba'ala v'shava beit avia. When her husband dies, she returns to her father's house. Ava b'chaye ba'ala, he eats ba'ala. When her husband is alive, she lives with her husband's family. No chatan, no son-in-law wants to live with his father-in-law. Interesting. Okay, anyway, so you want to build, you say to your friend, listen, I need to buy a plot in order to land, a space and land in order to build a house for my kid. Rabbi Akiva says, how big is it? 4 amot by 6. That's the size of the house. It's really fascinating. If you ever go to ruins or archaeological sites, at the time, the sites back in the settlements, even from the time of the mission, not biblical times, the houses are tiny, 4 by 6. The room I'm in is, I would say, 1, 2, 3, 4 amot by, I don't know, 20, 10 amot. It's like, not by 10 amot, but yeah, maybe 15 feet, had amot, a foot and a half. And this is like double the size of a standard house. They would live, it's like tiny. Even Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Shmuel says, no, that's tiny, it's too small. Revet Bakar Huze. That's a barn for animals. Animals live in a 4 by 6 house. How big is it? Arasela. So Revet Bakar. If you say I want to buy a plot for a Revet, for a barn, then Bone Arba Amot al Shesh. That's 4 by 6. But Bait Katan Shesh al Shmona. How much is it? A really small house? 6 amot by 8 amot. Okay, so basically if an amot is a foot and a half, 9 feet by 12. 9 by 12 feet, that's a small house. Gadol, Shmona al Eser. A big house, 8 amot by 10 amot. Trachlin, you want to build a palace for your kids? Eser al Eser. 10 amot, 15 feet by 15 feet. That's like a palace. Who needs more space than that? Now think about the smallest apartment that we would ever consider living in. When I got married, I lived in a tiny studio apartment that was not 15 feet by 15 feet. It was, I don't know, much, much, much bigger than that. It just makes you realize that if you would tell somebody the mission, the way we live our lives today, they would say, Yimona Mashiach, all we're just missing is the Beit HaMikdash, the Messiah has come. Rumo, kichatzi arko, how tall do you have? How tall? Kichatzi arko, kichatzi rachbo. So you take the height is half, there's no standard height, or rather it's half of the combined length versus width. So if it's a 10 by 10 house, so it's 10 by 10 is 20, so the height is 10. If it's 8 by 10, the height would be 9. Raya the davar, what's the proof? Hechal, the Beit HaMikdash. Because if you look at the Beit HaMikdash, okay, it was ayah arko arba'im. It was 40 amot long, rachbo esrim and 20 wide, v'rumo shloshim and 30 high. So it was a half of the sum of the length and the width. So therefore, that's the sum for everything else. Hakol kebinyan hechal. So you can read this two ways. Bartimaeus says you can read the first way. Rabbi Shimon ben Gamliel is the one that said that the height follows the binyan haichal, like we just said. That opinion is not somebody else's opinion. That Rabbi Shimon is Rabbi Shimon ben Gamliel. Or the Bartimaeus says there's an igad de amre. Rabbi Shimon ben Gamliel pali gatanakam va'atmuhe kametama. He probably means he argues on the tanakama and he's asking a question. So you read it that way. Rabbi Shimon ben Gamliel amir hakol ki binyan haichal. Everything has to be like the Beit HaMikdash. Meaning, everything has to be like half of the height, make a standard height or whatever. You don't have to have, the height doesn't have to be exactly like the Beit HaMikdash. Just for me, every time I learn this Mishnah, it's like, it reinforces how incredibly fortunate we are to live with the poorest person today probably lives a better and more physically blessed life than Shlomo HaMelech, most poor person, if you don't have food or you don't have whatever. But the most basic standard, electricity, the comfort in the middle of the winter, enough food to eat, lives so far beyond the standard of living that they had the times of the Mishnah. We'll stop here and dedicate our learning to the memory of my father. Have a great day.